Alright guys, welcome back for another video. In today's video, I want to cover an old forum post from Hal Finney back in 2010. I think it's now more relevant than ever. It's titled Bitcoin Bank. Now, personally, I think Hal Finney was Satoshi. I know that may be a controversial opinion, but all my investigations have led back to this individual. Now, I'm sure there are a lot of other people who could be or could have been Satoshi. That's not really the point of this video. I just want to cover this post. He goes on to write, actually, there's a very good reason for Bitcoin-backed banks to exist, issuing their own digital cash currency redeemable for Bitcoin. Bitcoin itself cannot scale to have every financial transaction in the world broadcast to everyone and included in the blockchain. There needs to be a secondary level of payment systems, which is lighter weight and more efficient. Likewise, the time needed for Bitcoin transactions to finalize will be impractical for medium to large value purchases. Now, we've kind of already have this going on in the second layer on the Lightning Network in Bitcoin. But I think here he's touching on the idea that banks would issue their own unique digital currencies to solve that secondary layer problem. And he goes on to say, Bitcoin-backed banks will solve these problems. They can work like banks did before nationalization of currency. Different banks can have different policies, some more aggressive, some more conservative. Some would be fractional reserve, while others may be 100% Bitcoin-backed. Interest rates may vary. Cash from some banks may trade at a discount to that from others. So what he's touching on here is that, you know, different banks would have different lending practices, different appetite for risk, and different procedures for, you know, choosing who they allow to borrow money from them. But he's also touching on the idea that, you know, when you're under a central authority of like a central bank, their monetary policy like conglomerates everybody together and sort of forces people into a certain pattern. Whereas if you had this decentralization, you could have a greater range of different lending practices that are possible when you're not beholden to the dictates of the central bank. And he's also mentioning that, you know, despite these different banks would have different lending practices, they would all have an incentive to hold Bitcoin on reserves. And I do agree with that just from my experience in the lending industry. I do think that, you know, there's an incredible incentive for any bank, regardless of your lending practice, to hold Bitcoin as a reserve for a number of reasons. But he goes on to say, George Seglin has worked out the theory of competitive free banking in detail. And then he argues such a system would be stable, inflation resistant, and self-regulating. I believe this would be the ultimate fate of Bitcoin, to be the high-powered money that serves as a reserve currency for banks that issue their own digital cash. Most Bitcoin transactions will occur between banks to settle transfers. Bitcoin transactions by private individuals will be as rare as well as Bitcoin-based purchases are today. So essentially, that's kind of the fate of gold, right? Gold is used because of its transaction costs to settle large settlements, primarily between large commercial banks and other central banks. There's a quote by JP Morgan, founder of JP Morgan Chase, saying that gold is money and nothing else. And that is the perspective of many large banking institutions. They settle their liabilities and their debt between one another with a gold transfer, gold settlement, because it's a final settlement layer. Gold is a bearer asset. They don't accept the credit of another central bank as settlement, which is a unique distinction I don't think a lot of people realize. But Bitcoin, for the same reasons that gold was used as a settlement layer, Bitcoin would also be used as a settlement layer. It's doing the same. It has the same properties that gold has, only more perfected and more easier to utilize. Now, I think one interesting point of this that he's kind of touching on is one of the reasons why central banks digital currency will not work. If you guys aren't familiar with central bank digital currency, or CBDC as it's commonly referred to, it's the idea that central banks will digitize their currencies and issue them directly to people and cutting out the commercial banks as an intermediary. Right now, commercial banks serve as the intermediary between the individual and their central bank. Because say if, you know, you have a checking account at Wells Fargo, well, Wells Fargo also has a reserve at the Federal Reserve as a member bank. and they are the intermediary. Well, if you issue a CBDC, all of a sudden individuals can have accounts directly with the central bank, directly under the influence of those CBDC policy. And that represents a end of business, a risk of ruin for these commercial banks. I mean, it's just totally devastating, essentially cutting them out. And I fundamentally believe that that is the main reason why Bitcoin will be adopted, because it will be an imperative. These commercial banks will need to embrace Bitcoin in order to survive. First of all, Bitcoin is the superior system to central bank digital currencies. You know, central bank digital currencies will be plagued by the same issue fiat currencies are, but even worse, right? Even more control, more manipulation, more exploitation. Things like the money being, having a certain expiration, being only able to be, spent on certain goods or certain transactions. So you can think of fiat and central bank digital currencies as being constantly exploited and having extreme entropy in the system, whereas Bitcoin is the only system where, the system reinforces itself and becomes more stable over time and contributes energy and work and money to its own security. And I think banks there's a natural market demand for that, right, to embrace the superior network. But ultimately, it will, I think, become a life or death issue for them from a business model perspective, that they have to offer offer Bitcoin-backed services or they're going to go out of business. Anyway, I hope you guys like this video. If you like this type of content, just like the video, subscribe to the channel, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.